Our weekly update with Jackrabbit Soccer. Laney Murdzek is with us, the pride, one of many, of Hudson, Wisconsin. How are you, Laney?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing just fine. Let us discuss Hudson in detail. We have briefly mentioned it in previous trips for you and your sister and others to our humble abode. Where exactly is Hudson?
Hudson is on the corner, basically, of Wisconsin and Minnesota. But it's in Wisconsin.
But it's on the corner?
Yeah, it's on the edge.
Yeah, not on the border, but on the corner.
On the border.
On the border, okay. And Hudson has many, many favorable stops, including some delectable items.
Yes.
What's your favorite place in Hudson?
Kenokies.
Why?
Because it's a chocolate shop and an ice cream shop.
And you have even brought some treats from Kenokies here in the past.
Yes.
Such as?
Chocolate-covered potato chips.
Okay, explain this process, because I've had them before. You brought them to us, and we're very appreciative. How did this all come to be?
When I was younger, my grandpa would always buy me, a lot of them. And they were my new favorite thing, and now they sell them in, a cute little package, so.
Now, is this something that is shared amongst family members? Are you and Avery on the same page on this? Or?
Yeah, Avery likes them, too. But I probably like them the most.
You like them the most?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you ever bring some back, aside from the one time you did allow us to sample them?
Yeah, I've given some to some of my teammates.
Okay. Has Brock ever had them?
No, I gave him a different. I decided to maybe not go all the way out there yet, and I got him, just a truffle. But it was really good.
Just a truffle?
Yeah.
I don't think you can say just a truffle, because a truffle is independent in its own right.
Oh, yeah. It was like a raspberry one. It was good, wasn't it?
He's asking Brock, who is off camera right now. She is, but nevertheless. Okay, what's the future look like? What are you going to do post-education and post-soccer here at South Dakota State?
Well, I'm actually not sure quite yet what I'm going to do. But this summer, I'm going to stay in Brookings with Avery as our, last hurrah together. And then we'll both be going our separate ways probably after that. But, yeah.
You're not going to go back to Kenokies and put some chocolate on?
Well, I'll probably stop back there a couple times,
okay.
Too.
But you're not going to make it an entrepreneurship?
No. I mean, maybe. Who knows?
Tell me about this past weekend and to go on the road and to play as well as you guys did. That was a big statement to open league play.
Yeah. I always say, I think the conference games are the most fun. They have, a little something different to them. And I think we, as a team, really went out there and played well and scored a lot of fun goals. So,
speaking of which, two Murdzek goals were scored. One in particular was impressive. Can you give me the details?
Well, which one?
I'm talking about the first one.
The ball just happened to land at my feet. And last practice, we worked on shooting. So I was like, I'm going to just rip it. And it went in.
You certainly did rip it. There's no question. And this week, back at home, I know I've asked you this before, but what is it about Fishback?
Yeah, Fishback is truly amazing, and, the community that shows up is crazy. And, being a fourth year now, I get to see and, have connections with more of the community members, so that's really cool to be like, oh, hey, I saw you earlier today, and now you're at my game, and stuff like that.
Best part of Brookings?
Best part of Brookings? Probably Fishback.
Laney, thank you.
Thank you.
We continue with head coach Brock Thompson. One of the best parts of my job is what you just saw. You get to see it every week, obviously. Getting to know the student athletes, getting to interact with them. We need something else.
Yeah, for sure. And we always say the best part of our program is the players. And, Lania, obviously a great representation of that. And just so much energy and so much life and so much, what I love about our team the most is just a willingness to just connect with each other and, easy players to connect with for sure.
Okay, now the serious question, was the truffle good?
Honestly, I don't even remember the truffle, but certainly grateful that she shared it with us for sure.
We talked about this going into that contest, you've had a history with Omaha, and they're a tough team to produce offense against. They don't give up many goals. You go on the road and put up four on them. You got to be ecstatic with how you played offensively down there Sunday.
Best game we've played as far as the attacking side of the ball, and just our forwards. That was the best game our forwards have played. And you're right. I think going into league play, they'd given up four goals all season of the and through the non-conference portion, and gave up one to NDSU on Thursday, but five and for us to score four really speaks to the performance of our attacking players. I've always felt, you know, we've played Omaha. It seems like we play them twice every year, but the two things that kind of happen is if you can score an early goal, the game changes a little bit, and we did that, and so it opened the game up, and certainly. They went forward a little bit more. There was more space for us in that moment. If you don't score an early goal or they score an early goal, it's really, really hard sledding. And so that early goal that we scored, where KB played Haley Christensen in, really helped us a lot to kind of open the game up.
Well, something else you and I have talked about a few times throughout the course of the year, it's never been that this team wasn't offensively gifted. It was almost as if they just didn't want to quote Laney, let her rip. Like, they didn't want to just fully go out there. They were almost a little bit tentative at times, but you'd see glimpses. And, man, I thought you were uber aggressive on Sunday.
Yeah, I thought the work that our players did to run forward without the ball was special on Sunday. And, you know, you mentioned Laney's first goal. I actually thought the second goal was a fantastic example. You know, we challenged Laney earlier to just be a little bit better without the ball. She's so gifted with it. She ran 100 yards to essentially be able to get one touch on the ball to score. But when our players are willing to put in that amount of work without the ball to get into dangerous places, it's really special. And I think there were a number of examples of players willing to do that over the course of 90 minutes.
When we look back at the first week of league play, you only played one contest. A lot of teams played two. And if anything is evident from the first weekend is that it's going to be a race to the finish because everybody's knocking each other around. There's a tie or a loss hanging on everybody's neck but you.
Yeah, I mean, you know, a race might be a little bit of an ambitious word. I think it's going to just kind of be a little bit of a rock fight. Like, you watch the games. Being able to watch the games on Thursday, man, you know, games that kind of twisted and turned throughout the 90 minutes. I mean, you know, UND was up 2-0 on Oral Roberts. That game finished in the tie, and they scored twice in the last 3 minutes. Kansas City-Denver was 1-1 in the second half. Just some really, you know, I would say crazy, but we've learned that it's really just typical Summit League soccer games. And the quality in this league is really high. And, you know, for those that haven't been to a Summit League soccer game, like, you know, now this is the season to kind of to just put your feet on the ground and watch. It's pretty special.
Yeah, it's never over till it's over, and that's not a cliche in the Summit League. There's no question. Home conference opener coming up on Thursday.
Yeah, Kansas City is a really good team. Maybe the Summit League team that had the best kind of non-conference resume coming into league play. A tie against St. Louis, who's top 25. Went on the road to Marquette and drew against that Big East team as well. And the thing that Kansas City has done over the last two or three years that makes them really hard to deal with is they just have gotten a little bit better each year. And so they are solid all over the field, hard to play against. We finished 0-0 with them last year. We were up a player for a good portion of that game and still had a hard time creating attacking chances. And so it's going to be, you know, a really typical Summit League game.
And then getting back into the Summit League flow, you turn right around and then you go on the road on Sunday.
Yeah, and you know, I think what makes that challenge difficult is obviously we jump on the road to go and play. We're playing a team that doesn't have a Thursday game, and so they have a full week to prepare, similar to kind of how we had against Omaha. And that preparation time and the recovery time does make a difference. And so it will be a really big challenge on Sunday in St. Paul.